So up to this point, we have learned that how genome has been maintained, that is how the genetic material is organized, protected and replicated. You have learned what is the composition of DNA, how DNA molecules are made, and then you have learned how these DNA are protected. And if is there any change, how that change is repaired. And similarly, you have also learned that how the DNA is replicated. We now turn to the question of how that genetic material is expressed, because the genetic information is stored as well as transmitted. So we will see how it is transmitted or how the DNA is expressed. That is how the series of bases in the DNA directs the production of RNAs, and which in turn directs the production of proteins that perform cellular functions and define cellular identity. The basic processes responsible for gene expression include transcription, RNA processing, and translation. Mainly these three processes are involved for the expression of genetic information. Transcription is chemically and enzymatically very similar to DNA replication. You know, transcription is the synthesis of mRNA from DNA. So it is very similar to the DNA replication. Both involve enzymes that synthesize a new strand of nucleic acids complementary to the DNA template strand. However, the main difference is that in case of transcription, the new strand is made using ribonucleotides instead of deoxyribonucleotides, which are used for the synthesis of new strand during replication. Similarly, there are some other important differences as well. For example, RNA polymerases, the enzymes that catalyze RNA synthesis, doesn't need a primer. Rather, it can initiate transcription de novo. So, you know, during replication, DNA primers, DNA polymerases, they need primers to initiate the synthesis of new DNA strand. But in case of RNA polymerases in the transcription, the RNA polymerases do not need primers. They can initiate the synthesis of a new strand by themselves. The RNA product doesn't remain base paired to the template DNA strand, while in case of transcription, the newly synthesized DNA strand base pairs remain base paired with the old strand. Transcription is less accurate than replication. There is one mistake in 10,000 nucleotides in case of transcription, while there is only one mistake per 10 million nucleotides in case of transcription. So this difference in accuracy, or this difference in mistakes, it reflects the lack of extensive proofreading mechanism during transcription. As you know, there is very good proofreading system in case of replication. Transcription selectively copies only certain parts of the genome and makes any number of copies of that section. So, in contrast, replication must copy the entire genome and do so once and only once every cell division. So, when transcription is taking place, that means RNA molecule is synthesized from DNA. Only some specific portion is transcribed. That portion which is going to be expressed. You know, all the genome cannot be expressed at same time. Only some genes or some portions of DNA are expressed. So only that specific portion of DNA is copied in the form of mRNA, And this portion can be copied several times and several mRNA molecules can be synthesized. While in case of DNA replication, this replication or duplication takes place only once during the life cycle of a cell, that is before the cell division, before the production of new cell.